Hello friends, and in this video I'll be helping you with the terminating and non-terminating decimals. So let's start. Okay, so here I have two different problems, and with this we'll be trying to understand the concept of terminating and non-terminating decimals. Okay, so let's start with the first one. So the first one is 22/5, so let's try to find the decimal value of it. So I'll write 5 outside and 22 inside. 5 4s are 20. Alright, we are left with 2. Now we need to put the decimal. Right? So 5 4s are 20. And you can see we get the remainder as 0. Right? So we can write the decimal value as 4.4. Alright. Now let's see the next one. That is 5/3. So 3 1s are 3. Yeah, we are getting 2. Right? We'll put decimal. Again we'll write 3 6 18. All right, we are again getting 2. Let's again put 1 0 over here, 3 6 18. Then again we are getting 18. Then we are again getting 2 as remainder. So you can see it doesn't matter how many times we divide it, we are left with the remainder 2 only, right? So it's a kind of a never ending decimal, or we can say it in other words that it is a non-terminating decimal. I will just refer it till here, okay, because it doesn't end. It will go on, you can go on dividing, you will get the answer as 2 and you'll never get the remainder as 0. But in the case of terminating decimals, you get a fixed decimal value and you get the remainder as 0 also. So terminating decimals are those decimals where you get the remainder value as 0 when you divide, but in the case of non-terminating decimals you don't get the remainder as 0. Okay, so if we talk about the terminating decimals, they are also called as a non-recurring decimals because their remainder don't reoccur again and again. Their remainder remains same, that is 0. Okay, as well as they are called as your non-repeating decimals because they don't have a non-zero value that is repeating again and again. Okay, whereas if you talk about the non-terminating decimals, they are also called as a recurring decimals because they have a non-zero value that reoccurs again and again. Previously we have seen that we were getting the remainder 2 again and again, right? And the other word for them is repeating decimals. Now let's see some of the examples and let's try to detect whether they are terminating or non-terminating. So here are some of the problems and let's try to detect whether they are terminating or non-terminating. So in the first one, let's try it. 1 divided by 4, right? 0.0. 4 2s are 8. 2 0. 4 5s are 20. So we are getting the remainder as 0. So we can say these are terminating one. So I will just write T for it. Let's try next one, that is 1 divided by 3. So I'll put 0.3, 3's are 9, 1 remainder, again 0, 3 3's are 9, 1 remainder. So you can see we are getting 1 remainder again and again on recurring basis. So we can say that this is a non-terminating decimal. Let's see the next one, that is 4/5. So I'll put decimal, 5 8's are 40. So I got fixed value over here only. So we can say this is terminating this decimal. Now next one is quite complicated, that is 45/4, right? So 4 1s are 4, alright, 4 1s are 4, 1.0, 4 2s are 8, 2, 0, 25. So we are getting a fixed value and we are getting the remainder as 0. So we can say this is also a terminating decimal. So this is how you can decide whether a decimal is terminating or non-terminating. So if you like the video, please hit the like button, do consider subscribing, and thanks for watching.